The depth node in Silhouette is designed to help us create depth maps quickly and easily. And we have a number of built-in tools that are designed to help us do just that. If we look at our toolbar, we'll see a lot of familiar faces because we have the rotoscoping tools available for us as well. But after the tracker, we have some depth-specific tools. So if we take a look at the constant, what this does is it assigns a constant depth to the image. And if we take a look at the depth preview, this is a viewer that's designed to help us see our progress as we go along. So taking a look at the depth view up here, which is a black and white channel, a little bit like the alpha channel is, except instead of defining transparency, this defines depth. So absolute black moves our image to the absolute furthest depth we can, and absolute white moves our image to the absolute furthest point at the front. And a value of 0.5 halfway through gives us our center value here. Now we have other tools such as the horizon tool, which generates up a little gradient for us. So it helps us to define the horizon. And we have a look at this clip here and take a look at the ramp. What the ramp is doing, we'll go hit D to bring us into the depth view one more time. This is showing us a sort of double gradient where we can define the left-hand size, the right-hand size, the center depth to bring us further or so closer or further away, and the left depth and the right depth. And if we hold down the control key, we can also use the on-screen controls to scrub up and down the depth distances. Well, then we have tools like the hall, which, surprise, surprise, helps us generate up a hall view, as we're seeing here. There we go, coming out of that. And a tunnel view, which defines, a tunnel. It's a little bit like the hall, except it's round. There we go. And we can define the inner depth and the outer depth as well here, in addition to the aspect ratio. But in addition to the specific depth controls, we also can draw in our own shapes using the regular roto splines. So for example, if I come in and just do a quick shape on this banister here, you can see this is looking a little bit weird at the moment. That's because if we take a look at the depth, at the depth view, we've got this banister set as a constant depth. So that's clashing with what we're seeing. We can also use, if I come over to my object parameters, we can change the type from constant to linear to radial to ramp. So different types of gradients to help build up that depth. And in this case, I'd want a linear, and I will set my far depth a little bit brighter, just a tiny, tiny bit brighter than the tunnel, and my right depth, again, just a tiny, tiny, tiny bit brighter than the tunnel that it's at. So as we start to bring that out a little bit more, you can begin to see the railing here, the banister here, begin to pop out from the wall. And I can even blur that up just a little bit to make that a little bit rounder to fit that in a bit better. Or even use the wrap to do an inner blur. And we can build these up and also use alpha channels to help to define different areas as well. So I have here a zMatte, which helps to define the sky. I have another zMatte here that is helping to define the grass, and I'm plugging that into the depth node as well and applying that as an alpha tool. Choosing my source, choosing what type, if it's constant, linear, radial, or ramp, just as we did previously, And here I can now add in a little bit of grass. I can use my final tool that we haven't looked at, which is the edges tool, just to add a little bit of structure towards that. And then build up the rest of the object using Roto Splines to very quickly give me my depth map. One other node that we have available to us, if I go to start a new session, and I use this ramp here, is we have a Roto Blend node. And the Roto Blend node lets us smoothly change between different object opacities. So, for example, if I start, let's just zoom out a little bit so I've got a little bit more space to do this. If I draw a shape here and check out the opacity here, we can see this shape, which is going to be left side, it's going to be absolute white, and it's already blending without us doing anything else, it's already blending over to the other side. I'm going to add another shape in here. Let's just add a circle over here. And I'm going to call this right side. And click on it and select the opacity and bring the opacity down a little bit here. You can already see that smoothly changing between the two. And I'll hit A just to bring us out of alpha for a second. And do one more shape in the middle here. And change the opacity on that one to black. We've got some smooth changes moving between these objects. Cool. So now I can take that output out as either an alpha channel or directly as a depth map. In this case, I'm going to take it out as an alpha channel because I want to use a depth with my ramp as the input and taking the Roto Blend, bring that out into there, and then use a alpha tool. Rearrange the window a little bit. And you can see now with that set to constant, that's going to give me a nice, smooth, customizable depth map. So I can still come in and do any other changes that I want to. Maybe add a edges over the top just to add a little bit more texture. Or to add some other objects going on inside there. So you can see how you can start to use the Roto Blend as a fast way of getting some nice, smooth objects that we can then either export directly as a depth map or bring it in to the depth channel to work on it even further. And that's a quick overview of how we use depth to generate up depth maps.